Hi, I'm Dr. Jerry Jackson, out with the wild things. Vultures bring up lots of images, mostly negative ones. Groups of ghastly, bareheaded, hunchbacked birds gathered around a dead animal, or perhaps watching an animal that seems about to die. The name vulture comes to us from Latin, and may have been applied to such birds as a description of the way they pluck and tear at a carcass. While vultures are easily recognized by their appearance and habits, they really include two distinct groups of birds, united by diet and adaptations for making use of it. Vultures of Eurasia and Africa are closely related to hawks and eagles. They have talons and strong feet that allow them to carry food and nest materials. Those in North and South America are quite different. They have dull claws and feet that are not adapted for carrying anything. New World vultures and our wood stork also have a unique way of cooling off. When hot, they excrete on their legs, and evaporation of the liquid from their excrement cools them off. That's why Florida's vultures, the turkey and black vulture, often appear to have white legs. The turkey vulture and black vulture, both Florida residents, are large and conspicuous, often seen soaring overhead, feeding on wildlife killed on our highways, or gathering in communal roosts in the evening. Migrants join resident turkey vultures each fall from as far north as southern Canada. The black vulture is non-migratory, and in North America is normally found only in the southeastern states. Both species are found through Mexico and the Caribbean, Central America, and much of South America. Turkey vultures are more brown than black, and adults have a bare red head and distinctive ivory-colored bill. A black vulture is black and has a wrinkled, dark gray head and a dark bill. A flying turkey vulture is readily identified even from a distance by the way it holds its wings, high in a V, as it sails effortlessly on the wind, tilting back and forth with each gust. A black vulture holds its wings straight out and does more flapping than a turkey vulture to stay aloft. Viewed from below, a turkey vulture's wings show a trailing edge of gray, whereas a black vulture's wings are black with a prominent white area near each wingtip. One of the stock scenes in old Western movies shows a desperado lying dead after a gunfight, and the camera pans skyward to show a turkey vulture circling overhead. Turkey vultures are found out west and would take advantage of a dead body, but the scene in the movie is often ruined, for ornithologists at least, because as the camera pans skyward, the producer emphasizes the vulture's presence by having it call. It gives a loud scree. The call is not that of a turkey vulture, but of a red-tailed hawk. New World vultures are mute. They have no voice other than an occasional forceful exhalation. They communicate by using other behaviors, including clacking the upper and lower bill together. Young turkey and black vultures do make a distinctive sound that likely protects them at the nest. Nests of these birds are in very dark recesses, a hollow tree, cave, or under dense brush. When a human or other animal approaches a vulture nest, the chicks exhale very loudly and slowly, producing a most frightening roar from the darkness. Black and turkey vultures are both scavengers. Lunch is whatever they find, which in recent decades is often roadkill, but it can also be other dead animals or rotting squash, pumpkins, or fruit. Black vultures depend on vision to find their next meal, but turkey vultures have the unusual ability among birds to find food by smell. Perhaps to take better advantage of their sense of smell, turkey vultures often fly lower than black vultures. And to take advantage of the turkey vulture's abilities, black vultures often fly high above the turkey vultures, following them to a potential meal. Meals are often widely scattered, but when one is found, it often includes enough for several birds. Thus, there is a great deal of social interaction among vultures, including an exchange of information as to the location of food. Late in the afternoon, both black and turkey vultures usually return to a communal roost. Those vultures that have been unsuccessful often arrive first, and they carefully observe others that arrive. Vultures that have found a good source of food will have an enlarged crop and stomach that can easily be seen. The next morning, the hungry vultures follow them. Winter in South Florida is a time when resident black and turkey vultures pair up and look for a nest site. Natural nest sites include large tree cavities, caves, a hollow log, or a dark recess under a fallen tree. In recent decades, as a result of cutting of large trees, our vultures have found other nest sites. They sometimes use culverts, abandoned buildings, or abandoned cars. When a potential nest site has been found, a vulture pair often perches nearby, sitting side by side for hours. This likely strengthens the pair bond for the long job ahead. Vultures build no nest, but lay two large, somewhat dull and mottled eggs on the ground. Adults take turns incubating, usually exchanging places only once a day. Eggs hatch in 5 to 6 weeks, and young black vultures are covered with buff-colored, oily down. Turkey vulture chicks are covered with white, oily down. Chicks share what their parents eat, getting partially digested meals by regurgitation. At the age of about 2.5 months, the chicks can fly, but often remain near the nest for another week or two. Young vulture chicks learn from their parents and are often dependent on them for food for nearly a year. With the Wild Things is produced at the Whitaker Center and the College of Arts and Sciences at Florida Gulf Coast University. For the Wild Things, I'm Dr. Jerry Jackson.